Hello, you are welcome to FOMA Solutions. And we've had series of discussions in our previous lessons concerning the real number system, proofs by mathematical induction, contradiction, contrapositive, and a whole lot. And if you've not started watching them, my friend, you are far behind time. Because in today's lesson, we're going to look at arithmetic, geometric, and harmonic mix, and see whether we can establish some inequality relationship between them. All right. So let's talk about arithmetic. So arithmetic, and then we have the geometric, and harmonic. So inequalities or inequality. Alright, so what we're trying to do in today's lesson. Alright, so let's start. You realize that we can find arithmetically given sets of numbers. So for instance, if we have A and B as any given number, we want to put some restrictions on them. So let's say that they are non-negative values. So let's say A and B are non-negative values. So we can actually find the arithmetic mean. So for this particular one, we're going to represent arithmetic mean like this. So if you say something like this, it means arithmetic mean. Right, so we can calculate arithmetic mean for this as the sum of the observations we are looking at divided by the number of times they occur. So this one, it has occurred how many times? We have two of them. So the mean for this one will be given as A plus B divided by 2. Good. Then geometric mean, in short, we want to write it as Gm. So we have geometric mean, Gm. So for geometric mean of any number, we're looking at the square root of the product of the numbers. So if you're looking at only A and B as positive numbers, is it? One may ask why we put in the restriction that the numbers should be greater than zero. Because we have here geometric mean, which involves the square root. So once one of these numbers become negative, it means we are moving to the complex in which we are not interested in as at this moment. So we find the geometric mean for this to be the root of A and multiplying by B. Alright, so we move on and look at the harmonic mean. So harmonic, so we represent that with this harmonic mean. And harmonic mean looks quite interesting because it says that whatever are the number of values we are looking at, all the observations will be written first. So we have two of this, A, B, so we have two of that. Then divided by the reciprocal of the numbers. So A is here, then each reciprocal gives us this, then plus B is there, then each reciprocal gives us this. So this basically is a harmonic mean. So we have arithmetic mean, geometric mean, and the harmonic mean. Then we want to see proof that this particular the arithmetic mean, given any set of numbers, arithmetic mean is greater than or equal to the geometric mean, and the geometric mean is greater than or equal to the harmonic mean. So we're trying to prove something like this, that the arithmetic mean A is greater than or equal to the harmonic mean. So we have the H N, the geometric mean. We prove that this one is greater than the geometric mean, and the geometric mean is also greater than or equal to the harmonic mean. Alright. So to prove that, we can pick them one after the other. So if we are able to show that arithmetic mean is greater than or equal to geometric mean, and subsequently show that geometric mean is greater than or equal to harmonic mean, then it presupposes that arithmetic mean is also greater than or equal to the harmonic mean, and that will be all. Alright, so let's see how we are proving that. So we have just made this known that arithmetic mean can be written like this. So in place of this, so we pick the first one for arithmetic mean and geometric mean. So for arithmetic mean, we have an A plus B divided by 2. And the inequality we're trying to consider is this, that is greater than or equal to the geometric mean. And so we have greater than or equal to the geometric mean here gives us root of E. Now at this point, we would like to square both sides. So squaring this side, and that's we're going to have here A plus B divided by 2 all squared will give us A, because the square of this removes the square root symbol. So we simplify this. So expanding the numerator, we have A squared plus 2AB and plus B squared, which actually gives us 4AB, because we realize that 2 here will actually work on A plus B, so you get A plus B all squared, which when simplified gives us this. And 2, this will give us 2 raised to the power 2, giving us 4. So by simply cross multiplying, you get something like this. So we're trying to see if we can transpose this from this side to this side. So that, alright, so the signs are inequality signs. So we bring this to this side. We have A squared, so we have plus 2AB, alright, so minus 4AB plus B squared is greater than or equal to 0. Alright, so at this point we can rewrite this as A squared minus 2AB plus B squared greater than or equal to 0. Now this, we can still look at it. It resembles a certain expansion, which is E minus E raised to the power 2 greater than or equal to 0. So here, we only look at this and look at our earlier proposition that A and B are values such that they are greater than 0. If we started with it as A and B are values which are positive, not negative values, it means that when we subtract one from the other and square it, it's going to be either greater than 0 or equal to 0. It can't be less than 0. That means that the statement here is a true statement. Once this statement is true, and it is coming from the fact that we have made the point that arithmetic mean is greater than or equal to geometric mean, then this statement holds. So this statement holds that arithmetic mean is greater than or equal to the geometric mean. So the part two of this particular proof is for us to see whether we can establish some relationship between the geometric mean and the harmonic mean. Alright, so let's take geometric harmonic. The geometric and the harmonic. Okay. We're not going to any stage area. We're still looking at this one. So we still pick this. We say that from arithmetic mean, geometric mean, it means we are coming from here. So from here, where we have A plus B divided by 2, greater than or equal to the root of AB, all that we want to do is to substitute A divided by 1 over A and 1 over B for A and B. So for A, we are substituting 1 over A. Then for B, we are substituting 1 over B. Alright, so any place that we see A in this particular expression, we put 1 over A here. Obviously, B, we put 1 over B here. Alright, so at this point, we say that 1 over A plus 1 over B will be divided by 2. So we say that this is greater than or equal to. And we have index. So A is there, so we replace it with 1 over A multiplied by 1 over B. Alright, so good. So this gives us 1 over A plus 1 over B, then all divided by 2, which is greater than or equal to. Now we realize that this one will multiply. So we are having 1 divided by root, the root of 1 divided by A. So that can also be written as 1 divided by root of A. Nice. So we want to reciprocate our both sides, so we turn them upside down. And what we are doing that, obviously the sign is going to change. So we rewrite this one as 2 divided by, so 1 over A plus 1 over what B. And when we are doing that, the inequality symbol will not stay as it is. So we need to have less than or equal to. So this side, and so we turn this one to upside down, it gives us root of E. Now when we compare this with what we have, we realize that this one is the harmonic mean, and what we have here is a harmonic mean, then what we have here is the geometric mean. But the relationship that we've been able to establish is that the harmonic mean is less than or equal to the geometric mean. So if this is less than or equal to that, then it follows that root AB is greater than or equal to 2 divided by 1 over A plus 1 over B. And this is geometric mean, and this is what harmonic mean. So we say that, let's buy a little space here. You say that this is the geometric mean, and it is greater than or equal to the harmonic mean. So linking this particular one with the first one, where we are able to conclude that when you have it, so where we are able to show that actually geometric, the arithmetic mean and geometric mean, so we were able to show that arithmetic mean was greater than or equal to the geometric mean, and geometric mean greater than or equal to the harmonic mean. So we can confidently say that arithmetic mean is greater than or equal to geometric mean, greater than or equal to harmonic mean. So we have some generalizations too. The proof is done, but we can generalize all that we have done. Let's do a little generalization, and that will end. So generalization. Alright, so generalization, we say that arithmetic mean is greater than or equal to geometric mean. So arithmetic mean means that we are summing a certain given number, maybe E, I. So where E or I begins from 1 up to N. So this is the sum of certain numbers up to N. And to find the mean means that we have to divide the sum of this by N. So we can just multiply it by 1 over N. So we have this. And this should also be greater than or equal to. Now if you look at the geometric mean, we are looking at finding the square root of product of the numbers. And product is denoted as this. So we use this one to denote product. It means that we are going to find the product of certain number I. So where I begins from what? 1. And is ending at what? N. But this is just the product of it. We are looking at the roots. that here we are looking at only two numbers, so we are finding the square root, if it were to be 3, that would have given us the cubic root. Alright, so but here we are looking at the multiplication action, the nth term, so it's going to be the nth root, and that nth root can be written as being this one raised to the power 1 over n. Right. So this should be greater than or equal to then the harmonic ring. Now the harmonic ring, the one is here. So because the values are only 2, so you have 2 then divided by. But now that we are looking at numbers up to n, then you can say that it's going to be about n then divided by. But what do we have? 1 over the first one number, plus 1 over the second number, 1 over the third number, and it continues if we have more than 2 numbers being looked at. So on that grounds, we say that we are adding, okay, so 1 over certain number, I. So where I begins from 1 and ends at n. Alright, so this is a generalization as far as arithmetic mean, geometric mean, and harmonic means are concerned. Thank you very much for listening to this particular tutorial. Catch you next time for more interesting discussions.